Hello everybody and welcome back on my channel. My name is Alex and today I'm gonna show you how to make this part in SolidWorks. And for this we have this drawing, these dimensions. The dimensions are in inch except for this diameter and this depth here. These are in millimeters. Okay, so let's begin. We'll start with a rectangle and here an arc, and then we'll make the other parts. First we'll open a new part and here let's make this plain white and let's change here in inches, in inch. And now we'll open a sketch in the top plane and here we'll start with a center rectangle. Okay, now smart dimension will define this rectangle. Here will be 4.938 inches. And here will be 1.438 multiplied by 2. Okay, and now let's select this line and select here construction geometry. And now we'll select center point arc and we'll make here an arc, or you can select tangent arc, will be the same. And now we'll go to features, we'll use extruded boss base command and we'll select this contour. And here the thickness will be 0.5 inch. Okay, press here OK. Nice. And now we'll open a sketch on this face. And here we'll make that small cylinder and we'll select circle. We'll make a circle in this center point and then select this circle, this edge, and select here make coradial. Now go to features, use extruded boss base command. And here the thickness for this will be 0.25. Press here OK. And now we'll open a sketch on this face. We'll make that cut here. So we'll make a center rectangle. Something like this. And now with smart dimension we'll have to define it. Let's select this point with this one first and select here make horizontal, and then the smart dimension will give a dimension from this line to this center point, and here will be 0.75. okay, and now here will be 1.75. Because here I cannot see any dimension for this line here, so I guess this is like this and this is the dimension for this line. This line and this point are collinear, to say like this. Okay, and now we'll have to give a dimension from this center point to this center point, and here will be 3.188. And now go to features, use extruded cut, and here the depth will be 0.25. Press here OK. Nice. And I'll have to make this hole here, and for this we'll use hole wizard, so select hole wizard. We'll use legacy hole. Here we'll select counterboard and here we'll select end condition true all. Okay, and I'll have to change here these dimensions. So first here will be the diameter 0.5, will be the diameter true all, which in our case is 1. So here will be 1. Okay, and this is the bore diameter, 0.79. In our case will be the bore diameter will be 1.875. Okay, and here is the bore depth. In our case will be 0.5. Nice, and now go to positions, select here 3D sketch, and we'll have to place it in this center point. And we can see here the preview. Press it OK. Nice. And now we'll have to make another one here. But first we'll make a point, so we'll open a sketch on this face. We'll make a point so we can place it easier. And now let's go here to display style, select hide and lines visible. We'll select this point with this point, select here make horizontal, select this point with this one, and select here make vertical. And now this point is in the center of this rectangle. Now exit this sketch and we'll go to hole wizard. Here we'll select legacy hole and here counterboard again, and we'll have to keep here, we can keep through all or we can select up to next. And here we'll have to change these diameters. So this is the diameter through all, which in our case this time will be 0.5 inch 0.5. Here is the depth, but you don't have to change this because we have here up to next. And here is the diameter of the bore, which is, let me show you, 20 millimeters. You can see it here, 20 millimeters, and the depth for this bore will be 3.5 millimeters. Okay, so here will be 20 millimeters. 20, and we'll have to write here millimeters. And here the depth of this bore will be 3.5 millimeters. And here are inch. We can write here inch. Okay, now go to positions, select here 3D sketch, and we'll have to place it in this center point. We can see here the preview. Press it OK. Now let's go back to display style and select first one. Nice. Now we can hide this point. Okay. And I'll have to make the other holes. So we'll start with the holes of on this cylinder. So select this face, open a sketch. And here we'll make, let's start with a center line first. We'll make a center line just like this, then select circle. We'll make here a circle. Select this circle and select here construction geometry. And now we'll make a point. Make a point on this circle and then make another center line from this center point to this point. And now smart dimension will have to give a diameter for this circle, and here will be 2.375 inches. Okay, so will be 2.375. Okay, and now the angle between these two center lines here will be 15 degrees. Nice, and now in this point will be placed a hole with hole wizard. Now we'll have to exit this sketch and we'll go to hole wizard, and now we'll go to this one, straight tap. Here we'll select NC inch. We'll select from here tapped hole. And here I think it is, I'm not quite sure about these dimensions because I don't usually use inches. So I guess here will be 1 divided by 4 and 28. And we'll have to set this dimension for the depth of the hole and this one for the depth of the thread. And if this is not the right dimension, which I am choosing here, please let me know in the comment section. So here I will look for this one, 1, 4, 28. I'm not sure if this is the right one because I don't usually use this standard, but I'm just guessing. So here will be blind and the depth will be 0.62 and here will be 0.37. Okay, here we don't need this one. Here you can select this one and I guess this is it. Now go to positions, select here 3D sketch and we'll have to place this hole in this point. Press OK. Nice, and now we'll have to make 12 of them. So go to circular pattern and here for direction we'll have to select this edge. Here will be 12, 360 degrees equal spacing. And here the feature will be this hole. Now we can see the preview. Press OK. Now we can hide this sketch. Right click and select here hide. Okay, so now we'll have to make these two holes, then this one, and then three of these holes. So let's do it. Let's select this face up to normal and here we'll go to hole wizard and we'll select also this one straight tap. Here will be the same tapped hole, but here will be another dimension and this one will be something with this one, I think 5 divided by 16 and 18. Okay, and now we'll select this one and here we'll select through all. Okay, and now go to position, select here 3D sketch and we'll have to place two of them. Nice, now we'll select this point with this one, select here not this one, select here along Z axis and now select these two, select here along X, select then this one, this point with this point, select here along Z and now it's my dimension. We have to give a dimension. Actually first let's make a center line. We'll make here a center line just like this and then with smart dimension will give a dimension from this center line to this center point and here will be 1.18, so 1.18. nice, now press here OK and now we'll open a sketch on this face and here we'll make a circle, so select circle. OK, now we'll select center line, will make a center line from this center point to this center point, make this center line vertical. Now its smart dimension will give a dimension to this circle and here the diameter will be 0.25 and from this point to this one here will be 1.1 inches. Now go to features, use extruded cut and here instead of blind select through all, press OK. Nice, and now we'll use mirror to mirror these three holes on this side. So go to mirror and from here we'll select front plane and features to mirror we'll select this one and this one. Press OK. Nice, and now I'll have to make three holes here. So we'll select this face, we'll open a sketch, and here we'll start with a circle. Select this circle and select your construction geometry. Now we'll select point and we'll place a point in this point. Okay, and now we'll have to give a diameter to this circle, and this circle will have the diameter 1.25. Nice. Now we'll select circular sketch pattern and we'll select this circle, and here we'll delete point 1 and we'll select this point, and here we'll make 3 of them. Here will be 360 degrees, equal spacing, and press OK. Now select this point with this circle, select here coincide, do the same with this one, coincide, and now in these 3 points will be placed 3 holes with hole wizard. Exit this sketch. And now we'll go to hole wizard. Here will be also this one, this, and here tapped hole, and here we'll have to look for 10 minus 24. I have no idea what these dimensions mean. And here is 1024, I guess this is the right one. And here we'll keep through all. And here this one. Now go to positions, select here 3D sketch, and we'll just have to place them. If I'm mistaking with these dimensions for this whole holes, I'm sorry. And if you can correct me in the comment section. Press here OK. And now right click on this point and select here hide to hide this sketch. And now we have all the holes. Now we have to apply some fillets. So select fillet. The first fillet will have the radius 0.375, and we'll have to select this edge with this one. Press here OK. And now the next fillet will have the radius 0.25, and we'll select this edge, and then we'll go up here and we'll select this one, and all four edges will be selected. We can see them here, and press OK. Nice, and this should be it. Yes, this is it. This is the tutorial for today. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next tutorials. And if you like it, you can leave a like, you can subscribe if you want to see more, and I'm waiting for your opinion in the comment section. Thank you, and see you next time. Yeah, yeah.